Short fiction, The Profane, written by Shakha and Nirvana. Call for afternoon prayer has just been played from the local minaret loudspeaker. It's the call for all faithful Muslims. 3 more hours is still needed to be dusk. It's the day of Ramadan, the day of hardship. After hardship, there's reward. Rewards would be in heaven for the virtuous, but for Cody, there's fire and thorn, nothing else. Fire usually rules the land, an air of desert. This month turns Cody's life into desert. That's why the fiery desert pops up in her mind at every Ramadan. The whole day she is standing on her feet in dark narrow lane, but get nothing. No buyer buys her body. What a whore can sell, nothing but her sex. Cody is a sex worker. What will she feed her tummy today? Poor Cody. All others get almost the same, but she has the worst luck. Ramadan brings a big misfortune to her body, to her trade, and to the business of all whores at this English road of Dhaka City. She must count lose. Cheap restaurants on this blind slum lane also count lose. During the day, eating and sex is forbidden this month. All the poor food traders here did business undercover before. But now it's impossible. The virtuous population hikes in number. Standing on feet, Cody is thinking about all those horrible changes. Almost at the end of the day, Cody hooks up a fish not big enough. She brings him up with no delay and falls on her cranky couch, 4 feet high from the floor. It's a small room packed with trashy old stuffs and almost occupied by the couch itself. Rent of the room is 10,000, too costly for her to pay. She starts murmuring, whispering with her client. The room is marshy and lightly dark and divided into 2 parts by a thin black curtain hanging on the middle of the couch. On the divided part of the room, underneath the couch, 2 elderly persons are waiting eagerly for something. They are waiting and staring at the curtain for the end of their daughter's act, the act of sex. Over the couch, 2 persons are arguing in low tone, and that noise are making annoyed 2 elderly persons under the couch. Why she is too slow? Why making delay? Mother must make iftar, the sacred food to break her husband's holy fasting. When her annoyance reaches at the peak, her mother suddenly bursts and starts buzzing Cody. What the hell is going on? What makes you so delay? Your dad is fasting. I should buy onion to fry chickpeas for his iftar. Hurry up, Cody. This sneaky generation is not honest to their trades. She was not like them. Cody's mother falls in the disgust of generation gap. Wicked onion traders stocked onion to make profit from its high price this Ramadan. It's a disaster in the commodity market, and obviously people are used to this funny crooked act. Scarce onion will be fried with chickpeas just after Cody get bucks from her today's deal. Cody fire up in mind, listening her mother's tone, but that doesn't show up her rage to cross the ethics of her trade. Mom, what's your shame to call me Sheila? Isn't it my name? Her voice carries her anger exactly as it was. Mother familiars with her daughter's temper. She becomes cautious. She can't pronounce Cody at this moment, because that name is smeared with her adorable childhood, not known to anyone except they. She did a nuisance job. 2 old persons on the other side of black curtain erect their sensual ears like vigilant dog. Whispering of 2 couch riders enters in their careful ears. Why you wanna leave? Why not you wanna do me? Do you know what would happen if brothel headman gets the fact that I cheated you? He will kill me and chop me up. You, the fucking good boy, lose nothing. Please let me go home. I just came near the brothel lane to see what's going on in. I am a high school student. I have some money with me. Take it and set me free. Please. No, never. You must fuck me, asshole. No way. Cody's voice goes a little up. Her parents under the couch listen. All these become irritated and start whispering to each other angrily. Goddamn of it. Stupid Cody caught up an underage boy. Shit for her. Once Cody's client left after the deal was over. Chickpeas and little much more are roasted with costly onion under her couch by mobile earthen oven. Sacred dish of iftar has prepared for her dad. The only family member who was fasting for God Almighty. The moment of iftar has arrived with a loud siren blow like the alarming siren of a violent air raid. Fortunately, there's no war at all. The old man and his spouse begin the ritual, start to mouth up holy food together. Nobody notices the holy rays glittering in the old man's socketed eyes. All on a sudden, Cody appears in the scene, pushes her hand in the dish to grab some food, maybe to take part in the holy acts. Something is going to happen. The old man rolls up his hands and pushes the dish up. He bursts into rage. I'm not eating anymore. It's now a profane dish, goddamn of it. The old woman turns dumb by her husband's words. Her word stock runs out. She just keeps staring at him with no wings at all. Mother may dumb, the daughter gets enough words to answer her dad. Holy shit, you, old farter living on this goddamn whore. How gonna be a hooker's money good, but her hand's gonna be profane. Mom, drive this old bastard out of this room. I don't need this shit. The rebel girl presses hands over her eyes and just gets out of the scene. Did she hide tears like a lovely little girl or like an adorable lover? Possibly she prefers to conceal Cody under Sheila's macabre. At that very moment, the rolling dusk shows up with its stupid words of silence. Call for the dusk time, prayer has just been played from the minaret. But its remnants has still wrapped up with the brothel's rigid darkness. A three-legged disowned dog is whipping in sharp tone at the open door of Cody's room. As if it just discovers the secret swinging between Cody to Sheila and Sheila to Cody.